pride is too small a word. A blessing is more like it. You know, to have been invited to participate in this story. How it impacts on me is that I was aware of this wonderful personage who set these people free. I never bothered to think about how difficult it would have been for her to become that hero until looking at the script and until seeing this young actress here to my left, you know, really imbue and carry that that role. What is wonderful about my character is that his daughter, Harriet, is an extension of that same conversation of his life, of a man of color who has bought his freedom, found his freedom, and is trying to do the same with others because it's the right thing to do. You know, I play her father, obviously. You know, what I loved about it is his integrity not to compromise her or himself and to remain true. And by that, you'll see in the film that he never wanted to see her because he never wanted to tell a lie. So every time she showed up, he would close his eyes so as not to see her. So when asked, did you see her? He could honestly say, no, I haven't seen her. Yeah, so that type of nuance in trying to find, in applying your strength to a moment like this, I felt, that's new.
And at a time when the world is still very much scarred by pain and divisiveness and prejudice, how much do you think we can learn by looking back at a heroine like Harriet Tubman?
That's a big question. I'm not too sure that we really have enough time to hit that. What can you learn from this? I think that depends on the individual who's looking at this, at the story. If you're a soul that's locked in a white body, you'll learn one thing. I can't speak to that. If you're a soul locked in a black body, depending on your generation, you know, and your culture, you'll get something different from it. I think that overall what we should all get from it is that the spirit of being, to find freedom is strong in everybody. In everybody, whether you're an enslaved African in America, whether you're lost in the Middle East, you know, or Eastern Europe, or in South America, it does not matter. You know, the freedom of your humanity is the most valuable thing that you can have. You know, and I'm not speaking in a material way. I'm speaking that, you know, just unhindered to live your life happy, you know, and do the things that are available for you to work with. Enjoy that.
I was shocked that I didn't know much about Harriet really beforehand, and I didn't know anything really about her story and what she achieved and what she did. I was surprised that it wasn't kind of a part of a wider curriculum. I didn't grow up learning about her in school, and obviously in America she's taught there from kind of day one. So in terms of getting involved, that was one of the main appeals to learn about her story and who she was and what she overcame. And I hope for a lot of people who see the film who might not know about her story, it will kind of open the doors to that. But, you know, she's kind of the epitome of courage and bravery and strength in the face of unimaginable prejudice. She was an amazing woman.
Can you tell us a little bit about your character? Because obviously this dynamic you have with Harriet is one of the more complex ones in the film, I guess.
Yeah, I think it is a complicated relationship. I think he feels very kind of tangled and confused inside about what he himself feels towards her. They would have grown up being friends, and at a certain age he would have been told that that isn't acceptable and that's not the way that life happens, and a line would have been drawn, and that must have been incredibly confusing. And it's pretty much impossible to sympathize with who he is and what he did and what he stood for. But I think he, deep down, whether it's love or whatever it is he feels for her, I don't think there was a language at the time to kind of even communicate to himself, let alone around him what that relationship was. So I think he's just a deeply confused young guy.
And at a time when the world feels very much divided, what lessons do you think we can learn by looking at this even more painful portion of our history?
Well, I think it's just a story that kind of champions courage in the face of division, that she's the epitome of that, and someone who overcame time and time again prejudice and fought for what was right.
It's an absolute honour to have you with us, particularly with this film, particularly for an international audience that isn't familiar with this iconic woman in this unique moment in American history. Can you start by telling us a little bit about who Harriet was and why her story matters so much? So
Harriet was an abolitionist who, first of all, saved herself. She ran 100 miles to freedom and then came back to save many other enslaved people. The first thing she came back for was for her husband. And then when that didn't go right, and when her heart was broken, she then had to figure out what was next, and then brought many people to freedom. But she started with her family first and then came back again, and she made many trips back and forth from the north to the south, from the north to the south. After which, she became a general in the army, a spy. She was part of the women's suffrage movement. She opened up her home to people who had been displaced and didn't have anything, and took care of those people. So, and the wonderful thing about that is that she died when she was 91. So, yeah, she's pretty cool.
I'm curious, I mean, you talk about all of the astonishing things that she accomplished in her life and the amazing woman she was. Can you talk about how you went about portraying that on screen and the preparation you did emotionally to craft her as a real human being, not just as an iconic historical figure?
I think I had to find the way in, because I think for so long we've been sort of told the broad strokes of her story and not really the detail of it. And I don't know why, but I'm sort of fixated on the fact that her story begins with love. You know, her story begins in a love story. Her and her husband were very much in love, and when she left, she came back for him. And it was at the moment that she realized that he was with someone else that she had to make the decision about what to do next. And I think that is a pivotal moment in her history that tells us who she was, the determination and the will to do what was right, even in heartbreak. And I think that I just wanted people to see that of her. I wanted to see the woman. I wanted to see the strength and the will of her. And I think that to do that, I had been given the wonderful help of my director, who was holding my hand like every single step of the way, the research and the learning and finding out just where I could put that in my body, and wanting to be physically prepared to do all of that. I had to do some spiritual searching. I have faith, so I would pray, because I felt like that was helpful and it was grounding. I worked out every day because I wanted to be physically prepared to do those things. Did all my own stunts because I wanted to be completely connected to her that way. I knew that the difficulty would inform the way in which I was treating her as a person. To go through all of those things would have been tough and almost impossible, but yet she continued. So, yeah, I did a few things.
At a time when the world is still very much divided by prejudice and pain, what important lessons do you think we can learn from this particular story?
Yeah, I think that in this moment in time, I think from her, from this movie, I think we can learn that even when we feel like we're insignificant and small, we have the power to make incredible, incredible change. This was a woman who had very little means. She was almost, I think, 5 foot, some people say 4'11", so small, and she was strong. And she was not fully educated, didn't have all the education in the world, but still she had ingenuity and will and the knowledge about what was right and wrong, and used that to change the face of the earth. We can do that. We have no excuses. We have way more resources, way more knowledge, and way more insight into what it looks like if we don't do the work. So we can use this as an example.
Yeah. There we go. Fantastic. winning smile. One more. Here we go.
I smile, but I don't like my manager grin.
Just on your right, great. Can you just do the dress again? I'm pretty
Thank you.
I'm not going to do this. So we're going to get the cast to join you. Eyes on you guys. Here we go.
Sorry.
Just one more time.
Thank you.
Great, thank you.
At 11 o'clock.
Thank you. Okay. Just on your right hand side, just down here with
another. Overhead, please, Katie. Thank you.
Chris and that guy, I don't know, it's not being on today.